Good morning, everyone. So we saw a huge gap up yesterday in Nifty, right? But as we had discussed from last week or so, Nifty is probably in a range bound mode. The downside 9750 and on the upside is 9960, right? So yesterday, after undergoing a big fall, breaching the important level of 9850, it opened gap up and tried to breach the high, which was basically towards 9920 mark. So as today is the expiry day, so it would remain range bound. Max on the upside, Nifty cannot go beyond 9920 to 9940 mark. On the downside, it's pretty much clear the gap which has been formed yesterday, it can basically go in that range. So on the downside, it is 9800. So predominantly this expiry, a big move will not be seen in Nifty. Let's go and see on a shorter time frame what has exactly happened. So when you see on the hourly time frame, this was the point which we had been discussing, 9850. It breached 9850, went all the way down, right? And then yesterday it opened gap up again. Well, this fall which has happened day before yesterday was because of the geopolitical tension of Korea. But our point was pretty clear, if it would go below 9850 mark, which was a very good support on the shorter time frame, straight away down to the gap was easily possible, right? So it did go there, going 1.5 times ATR. And what happens yesterday, it opens gap up and tries to go beyond the gap which was formed day before yesterday, right? So it was not able to go beyond the gap. So the high which was basically formed was around 9910. Now what happens today as well, it tries to open gap up from the yesterday point, but could not go beyond 9910, right? And a quick selling is basically seen around those levels. Let's go and see around 5 minutes level. As we can see over here, right in the morning and open up around 9905 mark, and a complete selling is basically seen over here. So on the shorter time frame as well, a quick selling was seen about. This was the gap up which was formed yesterday. So we will keep a quick eye on these levels of roughly 9850, okay, and even the smaller end of 9960 types. So ideally, if it needs to find a reversal, it will be around these range, 9850 to 9860 levels. But if it breaches 9850 once again, a quick sell off can be seen at the end of the day. So expiry can be in the range bound of 9800 on the downside. Okay, so when we see on the downside, it can fill up this gap. The 9800 is the stopping for Nifty for this expiry. On the upside, it is pretty much clear. It needs to breach today's high, that is 9910. Then again, we have intermittent resistances at 9920 odd levels, right? So pretty much a range bound expiry is expected. But only way to make quick money would be at the time of expiry. If it breaches yesterday's gap, a quick fall of 50 points can be seen over here, right? So one can basically buy a put of around 9850 or 9800 just for the expiry. But we need to be first clear whether it breaches these levels of 9850 or not, right? So if you see yesterday or day before as well, it opened down. It went down below 9850. It did test 9850 once again, and then a quick sell off was seen over here, right? So it will give you a chance even on the in between the day. So maybe post lunch we can find a quick selling if it remains around 9850 or below 9850 mark. So that's Nifty from day's point of view and from 5 minutes point of view. Let's go and see Bank Nifty. what store for Bank Nifty. It's pretty much the same as it was for Nifty as well. Bank Nifty, as we had already discussed, it is again in the range bound mode. It opened gap up, went up. Yesterday, it again opened up but could not go higher than these 24,400 mark. Right. So on the higher side, Bank Nifty has a quick resistance around 24,400, 24,500. These are like big resistances for Bank Nifty. So for the expiry, it is very clear it cannot reach these levels. On the downside, it's pretty much clear the gap which was formed in last week was around 24,080. So this point is very crucial for Bank Nifty. A big gap was formed over here and it had formed a green moriba, so it came back to the same level but could not go below this even after a large amount of selling. And yesterday it opened gap up and tried to sustain above 24,400 but was not successful. So Nifty and Bank Nifty, they seem to be in a range bound mode both on the downside and the upside. It's pretty much limited, and we'll try to see in next week, in next expiry, what can be the flow for Nifty or Bank Nifty. On daily point, it is very clear Bank Nifty cannot find any upside if it does not breach 24,500. So for our next expiry levels, will be very clear. For Bank Nifty, it is 24,500. Then we are buyer in Bank Nifty. And on the downside, it is pretty clear that two times it has tested these bottoms of 23,900, 23,800. Right, so that is the range for Nifty as well as Bank Nifty. They are within their plus minus 1-1.5% range unless it does not breach. Either ways, a decisive move is not likely in Bank Nifty or in Nifty. Now let's go and see in 5 minutes chart or hourly chart to understand what's happening in the consolidation mode. It's pretty much the same. A quick sell-off which was seen in Bank Nifty couple of days before, it again came down to the same gap level and a gap up was seen over there. Okay, it tried to go beyond this gap and could not go yesterday. What happens today morning, it opens up and a quick amount of selling takes place. So for Bank Nifty as well, there is not much upside as it cannot reach above 24,500. So it has a limited upside for the expiry. And even on the downside, the level of gap up and yesterday's closing point, day before yesterday's closing point, that is 24,000 or 24,080, is an important mark over here. Right? So Nifty and Bank Nifty pretty much at the expiry will remain range bound. This is the 5 minute chart. If you see over here, it opens gap up and straight away selling comes in. Okay, it tries to go below the gap and it is now below the gap as well. So ideally, if you want, we can be buyer of a put option roughly around 2400 kind of levels, because if it could not go higher than these levels, a straight sell-off is easily likely to 24150. So we can buy a put option 100-200 points below the current price. And we can basically get 200 points from there. So put option towards the expiry can be a good move, but it is going to remain range bound and it can also reverse somewhere. But technically Bank Nifty seems to be very weak as the current setup, because it is now below the yesterday's opening gap up, right? So if it cannot go beyond 24,250 points, it cannot be going higher. We can easily see Bank Nifty today at the expiry roughly around 24,150, right, filling the gap. So keep a quick eye on Bank Nifty. It seems to be more bearish compared to Nifty. Even on Nifty time frame, we are clear if it goes below these levels of 9850, then only a quick selling can be seen. Now, if you see in Nifty a quick bounce back, or you can say a quick buying, is seen predominantly after a quick sell-off in the morning. But as we said, these two levels are very important, 9860, 9855, if you want to be buyer in a put option. right? Even on the upside, even if you buy a call option, it's not going to give us much more leeway, because on the upside, the resistance is high at around 9910. So a good option would be to buy a put option if it breaches these important levels. And if Bank Nifty cracks, it will put additional pressure on Nifty as well. So we would be looking for a downside in Nifty if it breaches 9850 levels. Right? So a quick buck can be made at the time of expiry if it goes below 9850.